How much do these two want a podium here in Thailand? Well, this is how much. Acosta now flings it on the inside of Miller into five.
Supreme bravery, but also supreme skill between Jack Miller and Pedro Acosta. Acosta will now have the inside line for turn seven. He's back on the inside. This is all potentially playing to the hands of Fabio Gianantonio behind him in fifth as he now joins this podium battle.
Can there be a farewell podium for Fabio Gianantonio? Well, he's right in the hands, isn't he, there in fifth place. Acosta on the paintwork, he is on the outside of turn seven. So through eight now we go into this final sector. Magnaia 2.6 seconds clear of Martin. Acosta power sliding. Oh, big shake. Big shake. He was power sliding through turn 10. Got the big wheel spin and the head shake going through turn 11. Miller into the final corner we go. Magnaia on the last lap. 2.4 seconds he is clear of Jorge Martin. Clear and charging towards the biggest win of the season without any question for the world champion. Acosta half a second clear of Miller in third.
You've got to say the top two are both doing what they need to do. Bagnaia had to win. Jorge Martin just has to finish behind him and do that from here on in to win the world championship. Much easier said than done. Jack Miller, I think, has now lost his grip on potentially finishing on the podium because Acosta has motored clear and Jack Miller now goes way clear of the apex. He'll pick up a good slingshot there on the outside, but Gianantonio has taken fourth place.
That was tight as the Gianantonio, yeah, Miller's furious. Miller for so long on the podium places here in Buran, but he is fading out of contention as Fabio Gianantonio running out of time here to try and bid farewell to 2024 with a podium. He's put up a fantastic fight. He's had terrific late race pace here in Thailand, but I think he is going to run out of time. We follow Bagnaia then now into turn eight, which has called out so many riders in this Grand Prix. It so nearly caught out Martin seconds after we saw Marc Marquez crash out of victory contention. Some victory this will be in Buriram for Bagnaia. Through turn 10 he goes, two corners remaining. He's going to take the victory here surely in Buriram. He's going to narrow the advantage back to Jorge Martin, down to 17 points. He is still fighting tooth and nail for this third MotoGP World Championship. And Bagnaia wins here in Buriram. He gives it the big fist pump to his factory Ducati crew. Jorge Martin does take second place. What a huge 20 points that could be in the final reckoning for the World Championship leader. Pedro Acosta, absolutely sensational. Such relative lack of experience on those Michelin rain tyres. And he does take third place. A brilliant farewell. What a final fling it was in 2024 for Fabio Gianantonio. He's fourth. Miller takes fifth place, having been inside that top three for so long. Binder sixth. Vinales seventh. Joan Zarco had some great late race pace. He came through to eighth ahead of Aleix Espargaró. Alex Marquez, your top 10. Marc Marquez was 11th ahead of Luca Marini, Nakagami, Bastianini, and Juan Mir. There you go. It's looked like it's been down to two for most of the second half of the season. Mathematically now, we have just two title contenders remaining. Just two left standing in the race for glory in the 2024 MotoGP World Championship. And it is now 17 points in favour of Martin as we head to the Sepang International Circuit in Malaysia. Still very much game on.